What's up guys, this is Roy and welcome to another DIY video on this channel. And today I have a power bank kit from eBay and I have a laptop battery from my old laptop. Using this battery and this kit, I'm going to show you how to build a quick charging power bank. So let's see what's inside this bag is. This is the main circuit board and we have two USB ports, one USB-C and a micro USB charging port. And on the back we have a couple of LEDs. This is the heat sensor, power buttons, and this is the case. This total kit cost me around $9, which is pretty expensive. $9 you can get another power bank, but if you have a battery lying around you can try it. And first thing we have to do is open the battery and remove those lithium ion cell. So here it is, we have 6 lithium ion cell. Cell looks pretty good. Now let's check the battery voltage. This cell a little bit down, 2.7 volt. Above 3.8 is pretty good. This is 3.53. The voltage of this two cell is really low. It's near about 2.7 volt. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to use this GP4056 lithium ion charging circuit to charge this battery. And let's see, are we able to recover the battery? As charging, it's increasing the voltage. So after 2 hours later, the battery voltage rise up to 3.8 volt. I charged all of those 6 batteries and the voltage level is near about 3.85 volt. And if you guys are trying to make a power bank, make sure all of those batteries voltage level is near about same. Do not mix battery with different voltage level. Soldering on a lithium ion battery is not a good idea, but I don't have any other options guys. This is a Qualcomm Quick Charge enabled power bank circuit board. So if you have a Qualcomm Quick Charge enabled charger, you can charge this power bank super fast. This is battery positive, this is battery negative, and this two is for the temperature sensor. This is the temperature sensor. If you forget to solder the temperature sensor, this power bank will not work. It will not turn on, even it will not charge the battery. Charging this battery for near about 20 minutes and I find out that one of the batteries getting really hot. The temperature goes near about 60 degrees. This battery is dead. 1.43 volt, this is the dead battery guys. Make sure you check all of the battery individually. I charged Joe's battery for a couple of hours. Now the voltage is 4.1 volt. And the problem is those batteries are not able to hold the charges. Let me show you what I mean by this. I'm trying to charge my phone. The voltage is dropping rapidly when I try to charge my phone. It's 3.95 volt. Directly jumped to 3.432 volt. Charging at 2.6 amps is good. So within a couple of seconds, the battery voltage dropped from 4.1 volt to below 3 volt and it stopped charging the phone. Maybe this battery are able to hold little bit charges, but this is not usable for this power bank. Now I have another 6 battery from another laptop. So what I'm going to do guys, I'm going to replace all of this battery with this battery and hope for this thing will work. In the battery voltage again, it's 3.95 volt, good. 3.91 volt and 3.93 volt. As you see guys, I changed all of this lithium ion cell. Now let's charge the battery. It's charging. 1.5 hour later, I think the battery is full charged. It's still blinking a little bit. Battery voltage is 4.21 volt. This is Xiaomi Mi 5. The battery capacity is 3000 mAh, and I'm going to charge this phone using this quick charge DIY power bank. This battery is never going to die, and I'm hoping that this power bank at least full charge this phone. Now charge it. Battery level 5%, charging at 2.7 amp. The maximum temperature is near about 55 degree 63 60 degree. Guys, it's been more than an hour and I think the battery is full charged. Battery charged and the battery level is less than 25%, and I think the average capacity of each cell is near about 700 milliamps, which is really slow. And guys, I just want to say that this power bank board is really awesome. It's pretty expensive but awesome board. It can charge your phone at near about 3 amps. Also, it can charge itself at 3 amps if you have a quick charger. But if you guys want to make a power bank using your old laptop battery, I recommend you not to buy a quick charging power bank case because it's not going to work. And this is the front. You can find it. And light. Cool. So guys, that's it for today. Meet with you on my next video. Till then, bye bye.